Good morning, student. Welcome back to our math session. In last session, we see the introduction of data handling. Okay, what is meant by data? What is meant by raw data, group data? Okay, so today we see the frequency and telemarks. So frequency table, we use here frequency table. Frequency means the number of times an observation occur in the data. It's called frequency. How many number of times the observation occur in each category? Okay. So telemarks means here quick and easy way to count how many observation are there in each category. How many observation? Okay, in last session we see the table, that is the student of the class make models, robot, then windmill, a solar eclipse, lunar eclipse. So how many times they make? So here today we see the telemarks, how to use of telemarks. Okay, so how to represent the telemarks here? So here we use here 1, 2, 3, 4, and fifth line you have to draw like this. Okay, this fifth line is slanting line. This is a representation of telemarks. So you have to write this two definition in your notebook first. Okay, then you have to solve the question. And what is your question? See here, your question is, see here, this is your question. Okay, in a class 6 mathematics test, marks out of 15 are given as follows. Okay, these are student marks. You have to draw a frequency table. So how to draw a frequency table here? So you have to write here frequency table. Okay, now you have to draw a table. Okay, so first you have to write the name of the table. So what is the name of the table? Marks obtained by class 6 mathematics test. Okay, this is the heading of the table. Okay, now you have to draw a table. Here you have to write the marks obtained. Here you have to write the telemarks, and here frequency, how many times. Okay, so this is first you have to write here marks obtained. Second column, telemarks, and then next frequency. That is number of student. So first you have to find the lowest and greatest number in the given numbers. Okay, here lowest number, see here, sabse small number kaun sa hai? See here, this is 8 is the smallest number. So you have start from 8 to up to 15. 15 is the greater number. So first you have to write the all numbers, that is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, so you have to draw again sleeping line here to separate the row. Okay, here we have to draw the table. Now 8, how many time here 8? So we have to draw a telemarks here, 8. So right here 8, see here 8 8 8 8 8 8 8 8. See, this is one time, we get here one time, then second time 8, two time. Okay, so what is the frequency? We get here two number of two student. Then 9, how many time? Now 9 marks, how many student get? 1 1. Okay, this is 1 9. Then this is again 2 2 student get 9 marks. Then again you have to write here frequency 2, 10 number. Again you have to check the 10, this is 1, write 1, this is 2, 2, then 3, 4, 5. So 5 kaise likhna hai aapko? Do not write this line. So you have to draw this slanting line, this is 5. How many? 5, and this is 6, next column. So you, how many student get 6, 10 marks? 6 student. Then 11, how many student get 11 marks, got 11 marks here? 1 1, this is 1 11. Then only one student got 11 marks. Okay, so 1, right. 12, how many student get 12 marks? 1, right, 1. Then 2 3, then 3 student got 12 marks. So write here frequency 3 student 13 marks. So here check the 13. Here is no 13 marks. So you have to write dash and this is 0. No कोई भी स्टूडेंट को जीरो मार्क्स नहीं मिले. ओके सो यू हैव टू राइट हियर जीरो. देन 14 मार्क्स, 14 मार्क्स चेक द नंबर्स. दिस इज वन टाइम, देन टू टाइम्स, अगेन टू स्टूडेंट गॉट 14 मार्क्स. देन 15 मार्क्स, दिस इज वन सेकेंड, देन थर्ड. ओके तो थ्री स्टूडेंट गॉट 15 मार्क्स. सो दिस इज द frequency table. So here you have to write the marks of 10, then tally marks and frequency, that is number of student. In this way we draw a frequency table. Okay, so this is so simple. Again, so I will show you one more example in your textbook only. See here, this is your textbook, this is extra textbook, this is not your NCERT book. Okay, see in this book here, this question is given. Okay, let's consider the following example regarding the choice of tiffin of 20 students in a class. Okay, here idli, sprout, bread butter, again sprout, sandwich, bread butter, idli, sandwich, idli, and sprout. Okay, these are the choice of tiffin of 22 students. So here you have to draw table. Okay, so choice of tiffin, how many choice are given here? Idli, sprout, bread butter and sandwich. So here you have to write the number of times choice of student. Here 4 student like idli, so frequency is 4. Here sprout, how many student like? 6 student like. This is 4 and this is slanting like 5 and 6. 6 student like sprout, so write here 6 frequency. Bread butter, 3 student likes, and then sandwich, how many student like? 7 student. In this way you have to draw a frequency table or by using tally marks. So I will show you homework. Okay, this is your homework. Okay, see here, you have to take a screenshot and solve this question. This is 1 and 2. Okay, take a screenshot. Then question number 3 and 4. These 4 questions you have to solve in your notebook. This is your today's homework. Okay, thank you.